What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. So I recently took a trip to my local Target store here in Buffalo, New York, and I was able to pick up a few items, six items altogether. So this is sort of a mini toy haul, but I wanted to walk you through these. I think they're kind of interesting. I did notice at that particular Target, the toy department was a little bit wiped out, but they did put out some of a G case. Most of what was left there was the fantasy models, but I did notice up by the cash register, they actually had some Hot Wheels hung on the pegs up there. So one little tip I can give you is check up there by the registers if you're looking for Hot Wheels cars. Don't just check the aisle because sometimes it'll seem like they don't have anything. But then up near the registers, you can actually find some really nice cars. So I don't know if that's like that in every Target, but in mine, definitely there was some stuff up there to check out. So in terms of what I've got here for you today, we got one Matchbox car, four Hot Wheels cars, and a Spider-Man action figure. I'm going to walk you through these and take a look at each one. So this Matchbox car is a really nice one. So this is the 2019 Volkswagen Beetle convertible. And I'm a big fan of convertibles and also Volkswagen. So this one ticks off a couple of marks for me. And the casting looks really good. They did the taillights, license plate, they did the headlights, and the open top looks really cool. So very excited to have another Volkswagen in my collection. Paint job's a little boring, but, you know, just a standard glossy red. But in terms of all the extra details and so forth, I think they did a really good job with it. So, yeah, very happy to have another Volkswagen in my collection. So that's very cool. They also had some of the Ultra Hots. I believe the only one they had still on the pegs was the 68 Plymouth Barracuda. So this is only the second one of the Ultra Hots that I've actually picked up. So this is the more recent series. The one I'm really on the look for is this Porsche. Of these, that one really stands out to me. So I'm definitely looking to pick that one up. Some of these other ones are pretty interesting too. I really like that Ford Falcon. And the cool thing about the Ultra Hots is they have that special wheel design in many cases. And also they have the Spectre Flame paint. So very cool looking deco on these, and very excited to have another Ultra Hot in my collection. Next up, we got another Batmobile. So I was happy to find this one. This is from the Brave and the Bold. You can see the logo up here, and done in the sort of dark red color. I'd prefer to have it in black, but this is the only version I have so far of this particular version of the Batmobile. And this one's kind of cool. It's a bit of a throwback because it's got that sort of bat face on the front of the car. So very much a throwback to earlier Batmobile designs. And you can see the shape of this is quite unique too. Much wider in the front and narrower in the back. So you can see the production date on this is 2014. So this is a reissue of an earlier car. Looks pretty cool though. I really like the design of this. So very happy to have another Batmobile in my collection. Next up, we got this Ford Ranchero. And so this is the 1972 model. And one thing I noticed about this, I don't normally collect the art cars, but one thing I noticed is that the entire bed of this is actually done in die-cast metal, which is quite uncommon, I think, for this type of car in both Matchbox and Hot Wheels. Usually it's sort of like this part is done in plastic and just the tail end of it is done in metal. But this one, it's metal throughout. So that's a really nice feature of this, and I really like the look of the casting. And yeah, it's looking really nice. Nice chrome base on this too. Very happy to have a Ford Ranchero. So that's quite good. And next up, we got this Mustang NHRA funny car. And really love the design of this. Really looks pretty sweet. And one thing I noticed on this one, you can actually see up inside of the car as well quite a bit because of the narrowness of the base. So that's really interesting. You get to see a little bit of the detail of the construction of this car. Just because of the way it's put together. So overall, it looks really good. Really like the deco on it. And these funny cars, sometimes they're hit and miss, but I definitely think they did a good job with this one. So very excited to have that. And the last item I want to talk about is this Spider-Man action figure. And this is from this Epic Hero series. So these are 4 inches tall. And they're not too far off from the Marvel Legends 3¾-inch action figures I've been collecting. But the nice thing about this one is actually there's more articulation on this. You can see there's going to be articulation at the shoulders, at the elbows, and at the knees, and more hip articulation as well. Interesting. I can show you, I'll do a more thorough review of this, but I want to show you side by side by comparison to the Marvel Legends Spider-Man. And it is a little bit taller and obviously more articulated. And one thing I noticed is they were cut some corners in terms of the paint job. I much prefer actually the overall look of this. And the packaging style on the Marvel Legends version is actually much better too. But in terms of articulation, this one is far superior, and I'm looking forward to getting this open. This cost I think around $10, $11, something like that. So not very expensive. And I'm really not a fan of this packaging style. This is sort of this plastic-free package, and just in terms of your overall presentation, it's pretty boring, not very exciting at all. But this Spider-Man does come with a web accessory, so that's kind of cool as well. So in terms of overall value, I have a feeling this is going to be, as a figure itself, it's going to be at least on par with the other one I showed you. So we'll do a more in-depth review of this at some point. I'll get it out of the package, and we'll go over the articulation and so forth in a future video. So, but I wanted to show you this. I am interested in the series, and I'm excited to see what Hasbro does with it in the future. So we'll see what happens. That's all I have for you today. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you'd like to see more videos about Matchbox cars, Hot Wheels cars, and various action figures, think about subscribing to my channel because I will be covering a lot more of this kind of stuff in future videos. Until next time, hope you're having a great day, and thanks for watching.